Good afternoon. It's Wednesday, June 9th, 2010. I'm Jill Eckhart with your Erner Berry Market Report, sponsored by Erner Berry's 2010-2011 Meat and Poultry Directory. As a quick reminder, Erner Berry's Night at the Races will be held this Friday, June 11th, 2010, at Yonkers Raceway in Yonkers, New York. If you don't already have your tickets, make sure to get your order in this week for an evening of entertainment and dining with colleagues and friends. As an added bonus, we will be there with NAMP's new Meat Buyer's Guide. So if you haven't already secured your own copy, you can get one there. Call 800-932-0617 to get your tickets for Night at the Races. Today, foodmarket.com's reporting Allen Family Foods Incorporated says that it will be contesting a $1 million fine for safety violations at a plant at Maryland's Eastern Shore. You can get more on this story and other news from the center of the plate at foodmarket.com. Now, let's set the tone. In the egg market, retail demand is poor. Supplies remain readily available, with some sellers suggesting the only home they can find for eggs is in the breaking channel, which they can therefore dictate the terms of the transactions. Overall, the market is weak. Taking an inside look at Erner Berry's turkey letter, here's market reporter James Serpico.
Thanks, Jill, and good morning. Taking a quick look at Erner Berry's latest turkey letter, we find that the most recent turkey cold storage estimate is up about 13 million pounds. This is right on track for this time of year. Turning to our turkey chart, this week's focus is on South America and its increased imports of mechanically separated turkey, otherwise known as MST. Year-to-date from last year, South America's imports of this item are up a whopping 14,000%. This number seems pretty extraordinary. But at this time last year, South America had only imported 2.2 metric tons of this item. Cheaper prices and a favorable currency situation made for an attractive protein alternative, which was far more affordable than in early 2009. These factors, along with production losses after the Chilean earthquake, which forced buyers to become more aggressive in the States, have South America as an up-and-coming player on the MST scene, for sure. Be sure to review this report in detail on ComTel. Back to you, Jill.
Thanks, James. In the chicken market, conditions remain fairly subdued as the considerable lack of demand continues. White meat is moving at discounted numbers to our current quotations. Dark meat is available to handle current needs. The unsettled export picture weighs heavily on balancing the inventories of fresh and frozen product. Wags are steadier as supplies have become more balanced. Wings are not necessarily steady, but they seem to be searching for a bottom. Moving over to red meats, the bulk of negative pressure on boxed beef cuts is now centered on the round complex. Sharp discounts surfaced yesterday afternoon for the both knuckle and inside round. Weaker undercurrents still surround the loin complex as well as ground beef. In the boneless market, undertones for the fatter trimmings are generally weaker. Movement has been limited as of this morning. Asking prices continue to trend slightly lower. Leaner boneless beef is mixed thus far. Varying supplies of livestock are causing some uncertainty throughout that market. In the imported market, the Australian dollar gains some strength over the U.S. dollar. The latest data also suggests that New Zealand could be past their seasonal peak in production. Having said this, we continue to see buying resistance at current levels as processors have only average demand and try to minimize price risk associated with forward purchases. Some processors factor some of the risk into their bids, which results in bidding activity that is several dollars lower from where most sellers are willing to take on business. The market is largely unchanged thus far. Looking at pork, cash hog prices continue to depress as packer supplies remain sufficient for the week. Both direct market hogs and terminal hogs are rated steady to weak. Currently, the supply and demand situation for both hams and bellies appear to be in a general state of equilibrium. Trimmings, however, have come under some pressure as excess supplies have accrued. The market for fresh pork products remains amply supplied in spot timeframes. The higher than forecast rate of slaughter and overall lack of buying interest are contributing. As a result, loins, butts, and spareribs are all offered, and many at a discount. That's your Erner Berry Mid-Morning Tone on Comtel, brought to you by Erner Berry's 2010-2011 Meat and Poultry Directory. If you don't already have your copy, make sure to order it today. Day.